My dear son, before you enter the order of the priesthood, you must declare before the people your intentions to undertake this office. Do you resolve with the help of the Holy Spirit to discharge, without fail, the office of the priesthood and the presbyteral rank as a worthy fellow worker with the order of bishops in caring for the Lord's flock?
I do.
I think you are suffering, Deacon Emmanuel, because I come into you. How many years you have been in the whole process to reach this moment?
12 years.
12 years? It's a long time. How easy was for you this whole process of formation to reach this moment?
I can see the truth that it was not easy.
Was difficult?
Yes.
Yeah, it's true. It's not easy. But I ask you this, Emmanuel, why you are here today? Why, what is the reason that you are here today?
I'm here today because I want to answer positively to God's call.
And why God is calling you? What is the reason that God calls you?
God calls me to serve Him.
What is the reason why He's calling you to serve Him? Look at it. May I use this? In the read is that you choose is one part that is so beautiful. Because you are precious in my eyes, and I love you. Because you are precious in my eyes, and I love you, that is why I fell in love with you, and I call you to serve me as a priest. You have, Brother Emmanuel, your life in front of you as a priest. You know that life was not easy in formation and will be challenged as a priest. But the Lord has given you beautiful gifts. The day you were ordained, we have, I remember that day, a beautiful evening. It was beautiful. Today is a beautiful, wonderful morning. But it's a little bit chilly outside. What we need to do when the morning is chilly or the day is cold? What do you need to do? What do we need to do? Wear something warm. And that is the call. How much the love, the Lord Jesus Christ loves you, that he's saying to you, when the days are difficult, when the days are cold, when you don't feel anything, when you have the flu in your heart, come, wear my love, and I can transform you. He's sending you, says the gospel, to the world with wolves. How you will protect yourself? What will be the way for you to protect yourself and to be able to respond to the beautiful call? Is to fall in love with Jesus. Is to experience in your own life as a priest the mercy of Him, His mercy. Because if we don't experience in our own life as a priest how merciful is the Lord, how much He loves us, how we will understand and be merciful with the people that the Lord entrusts to us. How you can do that? You will promise obedience You will promise chastity, you will promise poverty, you promise all of this, and you say, oh my God, how I can do that? It's only when your heart is moved with love to respond to the Lord, to His mission. How He is calling you to respond to that. The people who fell in love and stay in love is because they date. Doesn't matter if they are married or not. Love is going down the hill when the people forget to date. People fell in love when they date. They have details. And that is why they conquer the heart of the other person. When you forget that, love is start to go away, going away. How you, as a priest, will date with Jesus? How you will make a time to spend time with the loved one? That he can embrace you, make you feel important, and see how precious you are to, in his sight. Date with him. Pray life is not something that we need to do because we have to do, because we need to pray. No, pray is go and make a time with the one who loves us. And surrender yourself and let him to love you. Pope Francis said that sometimes when he going to the chapel to pray, he fell to sleep. He recognized that. Sometimes when we pray, we try to let the people see that we are saints. That we are doing a perfect prayer. That we don't breathe. We are like, and I stay there doing nothing. We are not statues. We are human beings. We carry many things in ourselves. And the only one who can support us and will support you and will help you is the love of Jesus. Don't escape and don't find excuses in your priestly life for your prayer life. Because it's to make an excuses to spend time with the one who loves you, who are waiting for you. How wonderful is the Lord that He says to you, you are precious in my sight. What He sees in you, that He is in love with you. And how He's looking to conquer your heart more and more every day, that you will have the freedom to be His priest. The life of the priest is not easy. But the Lord is looking to help us to make that life easier. Because when we allow Him to embrace us, to love us, He gives us the freedom to do what He wants to do with us and to serve the people. Looking for that freedom. And when you fall in love, Emmanuel, with Jesus, you will have the freedom to be yourself. Sometimes we're scared to see inside of us. But when you are, and you spend time with the one who loves you, and he don't ever see as pointing you your faults, he always is looking for you to fall in love with him. That is the healing power of the Lord Jesus Christ, who will give you the freedom to enjoy your own self. If we don't enjoy, and you don't enjoy who you are, forget it. It's difficult to preach good news, because the best gift is you, yourself, in your heart. And to discover, and to recognize, and give thanks to God, because He sees you and He says to you, you are precious in my sight and I love you. Sometimes we're scared to that, to say I love you. We don't use so often and so easy that word. But that is the challenge. I will ordain you a priest. Mary says yes to the Lord. You are saying yes to the Lord. Hold hands with Mary, Deacon Emmanuel, and ask her to help you to surrender yourself to the love of her Son, Jesus Christ. And you will see how wonderful and great is life. That in the middle of our own weaknesses, the Lord is with us and help us to become instruments of love and peace. Relax and know the thing, enjoy the moment. Enjoy the moment. Be who you are, with tears, hopes, confusions, and everything. Is completely normal. You are confused, thanks to be God that you're confused. You are happy? Fine. You are hungry? Fine. All of these are normal, and you need to enjoy all of that, that you will have the freedom to be the best in this moment and enjoy this moment as the Lord Jesus Christ is looking to ordain you as a priest. It's such an honor for me to do this. I always say thanks to be God that I have Chasuble, I have Al, that you don't see how sometimes my legs shake. Because it's a wonderful moment. It's a great moment of praise. It's a celebration of beautiful sacrament. It's Jesus who is with us, giving us another priest. I be able to jump high with joy because of what we celebrate, and we have a new priest. All of this need to fill us with hope and joy. And we need to have the freedom with him to praise God because he loves us too. And how we give thanks to him because of his love. How we can say thanks to him because he loves you. We're thinking in that when we pray. No, all of him. And that is where we are together, giving thanks to God for this beautiful moment and being together with Deacon Emmanuel, the future Father Emmanuel.